Hello students, this is third lecture for the topic of probability. I explained there are two ways to calculate the probability. The first method is empirical probability, in which with the help of past trials we predict the future likelihood. Clear? On the basis of past trials, we find out that what are the possibilities for the future, and we solve some related questions. But here in classical probability, it is calculated for an experiment, just some experiment, simple. There is no past and future in this. And classical probability is what? It is the probability calculated for an experiment. It is calculated for an experiment in which each outcome is assumed to be equally likely. Equally likely means, like for example, if you are flipping a coin, there are two sides, head and tail. So there is no biasness in this. There are equal chances. Head may become, tail may become. So equally chances. Like if you throwing a die, clear? So die, how many faces are there? Six faces are there. So every face have equal chances to come. Maybe one come, maybe two come, maybe six come. Any can come. So there is no biasness. Equal chances. Every thing is equally distributed. Okay. Then what is the formula for this? If E is an event, E is an event for this sample space, this, then PE, the probability that event E happened, is down is total number of possibility. It is number of outcomes in sample space. And numerator is number of favorable outcomes, that is number of outcomes in event E. That is, n means number of outcomes. Number of outcomes in sample space. Clear? Now, based on this formula, we will study some simple examples. Like example number one. Find the probability of getting a head in flipping a coin. So if you are flipping a coin, clear? So what is the sample space in the flipping a coin? If you are flipping a coin, there are two possibilities, H and T. H means head and T means tail. Only there are two possibilities. Head and tail, only two, because the coin have two faces, two sides, clear? So head and tail. Now let E is the event of getting a head. If E is the event of getting a head, then what is the value of E? The value of E is only head, because only one option is there for head. So what does this mean? This means is N, the total number of sample points is 2, and E is equal to 1. Here is 1 only. So the probability of E, or probability of getting head, is equal to, what is this? Total number of points in event and total number of sample points. It is 1 upon 2. So what is the probability of getting a head in flipping a coin? It is 1 upon 2. Similarly, you can get the probability of getting a tail. So probability, if E is the event of getting a tail, then probability getting tail How many total sample points? Two. There are two here. And how many related with the T? It is one. Clear? So both probabilities are 1/2. Either you are getting a head or you are getting a tail. This is with the flipping of a coin. Clear? Now, example two. Let us flip two coins. If we are flipping two coins, then what is the sample space? Sample space is two coins means maybe both having head. Maybe first coin having head, second having tail. Maybe first having tail, second having head. And maybe tail. These are the four options. If two coins you are flipping, so total number of sample points are four. This is. Now there are various questions. Question number one. Find the probability of getting one head. Only one head. So E is equal to how much? E is equal to one head means here two head, here no head. One head is here and here only. There are two places where we have one head. Clear? So option will be HT and TH. So what is the values of NE? It is 2. 1, 2. There are two values. Okay. So the probability of getting one head is equal to, it is NE upon NS. And how much is NE? 2. NS is 4. Now you can make it lowest term, divide 2 by 2, 4 by 2. And the answer is 1/2. Clear? Another question is, you can get the probability of getting two head. So it will be 1 only, 1 divided by 4. Probability of getting two tail, it is 1 divided by 4. Similarly, another question I will write, find the probability of getting at least one head or one tail. At least one head. At least one head means maybe one head, maybe two head, maybe three head. Three is not the possibility, only two heads are the possibility. So in such a case, E is the event of getting at least one head. So what do you mean by E here? It is one head. So at least one, HT and TH. And at least means maybe more. So maybe both the head is also permissible. Clear? So an E equals to how many? 1, 2, 3. So what is the probability of E? Probability of E equals to what? Probability of getting at least one head is equal to an E, total number of event, total number of sample points. It is 3 divided by 4. This is the answer. 3 by 4. This is with two coins. There are many questions. Probability of getting two heads. It is 1 divided 4. Probability of getting one head. So it is 1 and 1. 2 divided 4. Probability of getting one tail. So same. 1 and 1. 2 upon 4. Probability of getting two tail. probability of getting 210. It is 210 is only 1 divide 4. Every time divide 4, because it is the total number of sample points. It is not S, it is N sample points here. Clear? This thing you need to remember. Okay, one question we will take with three coins also, because sometimes in exam they may ask you question with three coins. Let us flip three coins. If three coins are there, then what is the sample space? Sample space is three heads, then one tail, then one tail may be at second place, and then one tail may be at first place. Similarly, now two tails, maybe tail head tail, maybe tail tail head, and maybe all three tails. These are the possibility. There will be 2^3, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 options are there. Clear? Now there are various questions are there. There is no limit. Okay? So we will solve two questions here. Probability of getting no head. Probability of getting no head. Clear? So you need to search in E where heads are not available. Here head, 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 head. Only one option is there where there is no head. So it is tail, tail, or tail. So no head also means that all tails. No head means all tails. So this is. And how much this is? Here, if you count it, it is total number of sample points, it is 8. And here, how many sample point event points? It is 1 only. T, only 1. So, probability of E is equal to NE upon N sample space, that is 1 upon 8. So probability of getting no head or probability of getting all tails, it is same question. No head means there is no H, and all tails means there is no H. So it is same. Okay. And another question we will take, probability of getting two tails or two head, it is same. Two, let us write two tails. Getting two tails. Clear? So, how it will be? E is equal to two tails. Three heads, one tail, one tail, one tail. Two tails. Two tail, two tail, two tail. Here is three tails. So, two tails means HTT, THT, and TTH. And if you will count it, it NE equals to 3. So probability of getting event E means probability of getting two tails is equal to NE upon N sample space. And NE is what? 3. And how many sample points? It's 8. So probability of getting two tails is 3 upon 8. This is about the flipping of coins. Now we'll move to the probability of throwing the dice. How to rolling a die? Clear? So example we will take. Find the probability. Probability of getting an odd number in rolling a die. So if you roll a die, die means a cube that has six faces. So what is the sample space? Sample spaces, you may get one, you may get two, you may get three, you may get four, you may get five, or you may get six. Clear? What is the event? Getting an odd number. Let E is an event of getting an odd number. Odd number. Then, what is the value of E? The value of E is odd number. Odd number means that is not divisible by 2. And this is 1, 3, and 5. Only 3 numbers are there. Clear? So 3 numbers are there. So what? How many sample points are there? Sample points are there 6. And how many event points are there? An E, that is 3. So probability of getting an odd number means probability of E. And what is this? An E upon an sigma. It equals to, an E is how much? 3. And sample space, total sample points are there? 6. So now you can divide by 3 just to make the lowest term, lowest fraction, and it is 1 upon 2. This is the answer. 1 upon 2. And 1 upon 2 is 0.5. Whatever answer we are getting, is it must be all the answers. I told you in previous slides that will be greater than 0 but less than 1. Please remember, there are 3 conclusions we are drawing here. Probability of E should be from 0 to 1 only. Number 1, if probability 0, it is an impossible event. If probability is 1, it is a certain event. This thing you need to remember. I explained this thing in first and second both slides. Okay, this was the rolling of a die. But here you can see there are many questions. Like odd number is 135. Even number you can take, it is 2, 4, 6. You can take number divisible by 3. So divisible by 3 is only 3 and 6. Only 2 numbers are divisible by 3. Clear? Numbers greater than 3. Numbers less than 4. Numbers divisible by 5. Understand? So there are many questions we can have here. Okay. Now we will, most important question is the rolling of 2 dice. Example. This is very important question. And I will solve 6-7 questions in this. How it is rolling of 2 dice. So rolling of 2 dice. Rolling of 2 dice. 2 dice means on dice 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And on dice 2, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you will see, this is, we are making the sample space. First coin, first dice, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. What it is? 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, and 1, 6. If on the second dice, first dice is 1 always, second dice is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If it is second, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, and 2, 6. Now 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. It is 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6. 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, 5, 6. And then 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5, and 6, 6. This is what? This is sample space. You start from here and here. So how many sample points are there? It is 6 into 6. Total is 36. So now in every question, the denominator will be 36. Now from your book, I will ask you some of the questions. Question number one. What is the question number? Sorry. Question number one. Question number one is probability of rolling doublets. Rolling doublets. Clear? So doublets means when first and second both having same. Same means 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6. It is doubles. Clear? Doublets. Or you can call in doubles. Clear? So let E is the event of getting doubles or doublets. Doubles in rolling two dice. Clear? Therefore, E is equal to how much? Now choose what is asking. Rolling doubles, doublets. It is 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, and 6, 6. Only same. Clear? So what do you mean by NE? NE is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Clear? So what is the probability of E? Probability of E is NE divided by NS. It is 6 divided by N. Not, wait. I change the notation. Every time it is sample space. So it is 6 divided by 36. Now you can divide by 6 to make it the lowest term. 6 divided by 6 is 1 and 36 divided by 6 is 6. So the probability of getting the doubles is 1 upon 6. Okay. Now we'll take question number 2. Probability of getting A, you can call getting is 7. Means the sum on both the faces is 7. Clear? So what we'll write here? Let E is the event. This you need to write every time. Let E is the event of getting a 7 in rolling two dice, rolling of two dice. So what is the event E here? Now we'll move to the previous slide. 7. 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus 2 is 3. 1 plus 3 is 4. 1 plus 4 is 5, 1 plus 5 is 6, 1 plus 5 is 6, 1 plus 6 is 7, this is 7, 1 plus 6, and here is 2 plus 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2 plus 5, 7, 2 plus 6, 8, no, this is not, 3 plus 4, 4 plus 3, 5 plus 2, and 6 plus 1. So these are the options where you are getting the sum as 7. Clear? So only in these options we will write. And what are these options? You need to write here is 1, 6 is 7, 2, 5 is 7, 3, 4 is 7, 4, 3 is 7, 5, 2 is 7, and 6, 1 is 7. These are the only possibility. Clear? And if these are the possibility, now count how many possibilities are there. So NE equals to, count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Only the 6 possibility. Clear? So 6 possibility means probability of E means probability of getting 7 is equal to NE upon total number of sample points. Again, the answer is same. 6 divided by 36. You need to make it lowest form. 6 divided by 6. 36 divided by 6. And it is 6 divided by 6 is 1. 36 divided by 6 is 6. This is the answer. So probability of getting 7. Now, another question is given in your book. Probability of getting 11. Question number 3. Probability of getting 11. So let E is the probability. Not probability. E is the event of getting 11 in rolling of two dice. Rolling of two dice. Clear? So E equals to, need to search 11. Okay, where is 11? Here is 1 plus 1 is 2, 6 plus 1 is, here is 7 maximum, 6 plus 2 8 maximum, 6 plus 3 9 maximum, 6 plus 4 10 maximum, 5 plus 6 is 11. This is the 11. 5 plus 5 is 10. So 5 plus 6 is 11 and 6 plus 5 is 11. Only two options are there for the 11. 5, 6 and 6, 5. Only two options. Clear? So we will write two options here. E is equal to 5, 6 and 6, 5. Only two options. So NE equals to, it is 2. So probability of getting 11 is equal to NE upon N sample space, that is 2 divided by 36, because sample space is 36. Sample space will remain the same. Now you can make the lowest by dividing 2. In numerator and denominator, 2 divided by 2 is 1 and 36 divided by 2 is 18. Clear? So answer is 1 upon 18. Okay, this is question number 3. Now we'll take question number 4. Find probability of getting exactly 1 6. Exactly 1 6. Clear? If you are throwing two dice, clear? If you are rolling two dice, so what you are getting? You are getting two numbers. So what is the probability of getting exactly? So out of those two numbers, you need to have exactly 1 6. Okay, so first we will write, let E is the event of getting exactly 1 6 in rolling of two dice. In rolling of two dice. Clear? So is the event of getting exactly 1 6 in rolling of two dice. That means what? That means you need to search now E. What is 1 6? 1 6, 1 6, 1 6, 1 6, 1 6. Here is 1 6, 1 6, 1 6, 1 6, 1 6. This is 2 6. So we will not take this. Clear? So only these options we need to write. And how we are going to write it is, look, 1 6, 2 6, 3 6, all these things you need to write so that no calculation mistake. 5 6. Now 6 6 is not possible. Now 6 1, 6 2, 6 3, 6 4, 6 5, and 6 6, again not possible. So these are the total possibility. Now let us check how many possibilities are there. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So how many possibilities? There are 10 possibilities. Clear? So probability of getting exactly 1 6 is equal to NE upon sample points. So how much it is? 10 upon 36. Now you can write it into lowest form by dividing by 2. 36 by 2. And 10 divided by 2 is 5. 36 divided by 2 is 18. So the answer is 5 upon 18. One more question based on this rolling of two dice we will solve. Clear? So what is the, this is question number 5. All these questions I am solving from exercise. Clear? This is question number 14 on page 99, part 2. Find the probability of getting a sum greater than 8. So you need to find the sum greater than 8, means 9, 10, 11 and 12. Maximum sum may be 12. Okay, we will study it. Let E is the event of getting greater than 8, greater than 8 in rolling of two dice. Clear? Then E is equal to, first you need to write what is E. Sum should be greater than 8. Greater than 8 means sum maybe 9, maybe 10, maybe 11 and maybe 12. 12 is the maximum because 6 6. Here. So in solving these questions, first you need to learn this sample space, how we are making. Because if you can make this, then you can solve it. Okay? So it is sum 8. 6 plus 1, 7. No, greater than 8. So we need 9. So 6 plus 2 is 8. 6 plus 3, 9. 5 plus 4, 9. 6 plus 4, 10. 11, 10, 9. And 12, 11, 10 and 9. Only these are the options. Rest options are 8 or less, but we need greater than 8. Greater than 8 means 9, 10, 11, 12. These are the values. Okay. So all these values we will write here with the 3, 6. Starting with 3, 6. 3, 6. 4, 6. 3, 6, 4, 6. And 5, 6. And 6, 6. This is when we choose the 6 as the last number. Now 5 we are choosing. It is 4, 5. And 5, 5. And 6, 5. Now 4 as the last number is 5, 4. And 6, 4. Now 3 as the last number, and it will be 6, 3 only. These are the possibilities. It is what we have taken, 6 as the second number, 5 as the second number, 4 as the second number, and 3 as the second number. And if you will see, n e is equal to how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So there are total 10. Clear? All these values you need to write from the table, from that table. Clear? Now, we will solve the question. So probability of E, probability of getting sum greater than 8 means probability of getting sum, what sum? 9, 10, 11 and 12. So what is this? This is N E divided by N sample space. What is N E? N E is 10. It is 36. So if you want to make it lowest, so you need to divide by 2. So 36 divided by 2. 10 divided by 2 is 5. 36 divided by 2 is 18. So the answer is 5 upon 18. Clear? One more question I want to solve here that is also looking nice. It is question number 12, part 1 on page 99, and we are solving 6th question for this rolling of double die. Calculate the probability of getting first die is odd. First die is odd. Means the first number is odd means 1, 3, 5. First number. Second number there is no condition. But first number must be odd. That is first number should be 1, 3 and 5. Clear? So what we do? Let E is the event of getting odd number on first die. So E is equal to how much? First die, it is 1, 1. Second is no condition. 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, and 1, 6. This is when we choose 1 at the first. Now we'll choose 3. 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. And then we'll choose 5. 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, and 5, 6. These are the total possibility because the first number should be 1, 3, 5. Second number may be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So, how many events are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 plus 6, 12 plus 6 is 18. Okay. So, what is the probability of E? Probability of E means probability of getting odd number on first die. So it is how much an E upon n sample space, it is 18 upon 36. You can make lowest by dividing by 18, because 18 is the factor of 36. That's why I divide by 18 directly. 18 divided by 18 is 1, 36 divided by 18 is 2. So the answer is 1 upon 2. Clear? And before closing this video, I want to tell you one very important thing. And what is that very important thing? That if we have only one, then we are calling it a die. But if we have two or more, then we call them die. So die is a singular word. If you are throwing one cube only, that is a die. If you are throwing two or more cubes, then they are dice. So die is a singular word, while dice is a plural word. Okay, so that's all, my dear friends, about this classical probability. In the next lecture, we will start another new topic, complement of an event. Thank you very much.